So good morning, welcome to the Zombie Friday morning. Today we are going to work through some balance transitions. So at some point it might be a little bit challenging, even myself and I was kind of bringing this together to find it quite challenging in parts. So it's okay to take a little step back. If you can't complete the sequence, just give yourself a little rest, okay? It's gonna be quite tiring on the glutes and the legs at some point, but we're just gonna start nicely just by lying down. Okay, taking the legs out nice and wide, gently rolling down the spine, just bring it back to the head to the mat, and just closing the eyes. So just feeling a little toe side roll out, and kind of smooth out the buttocks so that they're nice and soft onto the mat, so as much of the length of the spine gently grounded into the mat. Okay. Hands just gently resting on the tummy as we find our breath, well it's always there, but as we connect with it, just being aware. A nice air and flow of breath. And as you bring yourself into this lovely still point before we start, just maybe setting an intention just to keep revisiting the breath. Sometimes we're focusing very much on the movement or something that we're doing, and we will inadvertently be holding the breath, we'll be breathing very fast. The breath pattern changes in many different ways to reflect how we're feeling. So at those points where you're feeling like your body is maybe in a little bit of stress or tension, just take it back to the breath, and it doesn't matter if you step out of the movement. So we will be starting this as a gentle mobilisation, just kind of wake ourselves up. Love this. We'll slide legs and feet together, just reaching out to each heel to find a full extension through our legs, the awareness to the whole leg right up to the ends of the toes, and then we'll just float the arms up and over the head. Just relaxing into the shoulders, into the ribcage, and reaching out to the fingers. Just lengthening out the body here, and we flood that breath right through the fingertips to the soles of the feet. And then on our inhale, we'll bring the arms all the way back down. We'll walk the feet in. Okay, lift the bum slightly and gently smooth that back into the mat. Relax out through your shoulder blades. Hold the knees into the chest. Lovely. And we're just gonna start with very simple leg raises with our right leg. So we'll take the right leg up to the sky. And then we'll just swing it up and down. So we're all very familiar with these lovely leg raises. Remember, we don't want to put pressure into our left foot. We're just stabilizing by grounding the foot into the mat, letting that right leg be as nice and free and easy as we can. Lovely. And then once we bring it all the way, we're going to catch behind the thigh or maybe behind the calf, grow tension to extending through to the heel. Draw the toe down and just gently lengthening the leg over the head by bending the elbows. Reaching up into that heel, relaxing into our butt cheeks. So breath is a very powerful tool and a system here to help with this. Lovely. And then we'll come into our half happy baby. So we'll catch hold of the right little toe side, bend that right knee out wide. Let the knee, left knee drop out a little bit and just draw that right knee down towards the mat. Trying to keep the heel above the back of the knee rather than swing it out to the side of the mat. So good, we'll sort of draw down with that right hand. Lovely, then we're going to cross the right leg all the way over the left. Lift the 2 feet off the mat. Simple supine pigeon pose, drawing the thighs centrally into the abdominal wall, and let the feet nicely relax here. Good, so we're lengthening down to our tailbone here. And then as we slide the hands down, coming into our supine cow stays closer. So really splaying the left foot across towards the left elbow, sorry, towards the right elbow, and gently drawing the feet back and down here. So primarily feeling this strongly in the right glute, but also in that left hip as well. Breathe and lengthen out to the tailbone. So feel like you're going to really curl that tail right down into the mat. Flatten into the back as much as we can. Okay, so then we'll just gently unhook the legs, pop them back down on the mat. Make sure we're still smooth right across our back bodies. Take the arms away from the body. And that left leg is going up. Same thing here. Some lovely leg raises. And again, we're just trying to create freedom of movement in that left leg. Grounded with our right foot, so there's no push and pull, it's just gently swinging up and down. Just freeing up that little bit of movement, and then when we bring it up, we'll catch behind, maybe up behind the calf, and again, just gently, elbows out to the sides of the rooms, heel up, toes down, relax into the back body. So as you breathe in, just imagine all those lovely old hamstring muscles gently releasing as you exhale. Letting attention right up to that heel. Lovely, and then we'll catch hold of our left little toe side, bring the knee out wide, half up a baby, letting the right knee kind of drop out to counterbalance. Because when you're working on one side, you might just tip off. We want to keep the back really grounded into the mat here. So gently drawing that knee down, gently opening that lovely hip. So good intention with that left arm to bring down that foot. And then we'll wrap that left leg all the way over the right, coming into just our supine pigeon, very gentle modified pigeon. So the feet are nice and relaxed, and we're just gently drawing the thighs centrally. So again, we'll feel this mostly in our left butt cheeks. So feel like you're pressing the butt cheeks down into the mat a little bit. And then when we slide the hands down, we're coming into our supine cow space legs. So we sway out the lower leg a little bit wider and draw the feet back and down. And again, intention to lengthen the spine here. Good. Draw the feet back, drawing the feet down. Lovely. And then unravel the legs, take the 2 feet to the mat. Okay. Bring the hips width 2 to 3 inches to the buttocks, plant the hands on the mat as we push into the feet, just gently roll those lovely hips up. And move into bridge pose. Just grounding into the feet, lifting the hips, lengthening forward over the thighs to the knees and through the rib cage to the upper chest wall. Lovely. And then we'll take the bum back down, take the hands and just gently slide them in underneath the buttocks, just towards the lower edge to create that lower back connection to the mat. Take the 2 legs up to the sky. And from here, we'll take a nice big inhale. And exhale, a third of the way down. When I next exhale, 2/3 of the way down. On our next exhale, nearly all the way, almost to the mat. And then point those lovely toes and float the legs back up. Press back up to the heels, flex the feet. Exhale, 1/3 of the way down. Pull that belly button right through to the spine. And go with your breath, exhaling 2/3 of the way down. Exhaling nearly all the way down. Point those toes, float those legs up, flex the feet again. Exhaling 1/3 of the way down. Exhaling 2/3. Exhaling almost to the mat. Point those toes, float the legs up. Lovely bend the knees. So feet to hips width 2 to 3 inches away from the buttocks. And we'll inhale, roll it back up into our bridge pose. And then as we lower down, okay, extend the legs up to the sky, supine dandasana, reaching up to the heels, and then extending the arms overhead, thumb tip on the floor. Relax that rib cage, press up to the heels, lift that belly button in. And when you exhale, rolling up to our seated dandasana, lifting right up through the spine to the crown of the head. Lovely. We're going to twist out to the left, reach down to our right middle toe side. Lift up that lovely right leg, press out to the heel, and gently keep that little twist going. So you can be holding onto the side of the calf as well if you can't reach your foot. And then we're going to crisscross that lovely left arm over to the instep of our left foot. Bend the elbows and give that leg a little extra lift up. Good. If you're rolling back onto your tailbone, press your sit bone into the mat. Bend the elbows to lift that leg up just a little bit higher. Lovely. And then we'll release that leg down. Reach up to the sky again. Seated dandasana as you reach out to the right this time. Extend around to our right hand toe side with our left hand. Lift that leg up. Reach across. Press out to our left here. Good. So again, if you're feeling that you're rolling back, just lift your right butt and push that sit bone into the mat. And then we'll reach across with our right hand, bend the elbows, get that leg a little extra lift up. And again, butt cheek into the mat, heel lifted, shoulders relaxed. Beautiful. As we lower that leg with the soles of the feet together, send the knees out nice and wide, gently holding around the toes a little length in the spine, pressing the side edges of the thighs down gently to the mat. Into our seated cobbler's pose, feeling that we're using the strength that we have in our legs to press the knees out wide. Lovely, and then we'll cross those beautiful legs over, step back into our plank pose. Pressing the floor away with our hands and really hugging that tummy in to gently pop the knees onto the mat. Exhale, shoulders go forward, inhale into our cobra pose. Exhaling as we lift the hips and come back into our downward facing dog. Let's gently walk the legs and feet out here. Okay, just rolling out over the balls of the feet into the backs of the toes. And gluing those lovely hands and lengthening through the arms, lengthening through the spine. And we'll gently put those fluffy feet down to the mat and just rest back towards those heels. Okay, draw the shoulders away from the ears. Lovely. So we'll glue that lovely left leg and inhale, float the right leg up to the sky. Okay, and then bend the knee and use the knee as the highest point here. Excuse me. And keep those shoulders nice and level out. Good. Keep pressing that knee up. Keep dropping into your left heel. Good. So we're going to take that right little toe side to our left, little finger side, side edge of the foot, squeeze those inside thighs together. And just draw the left hip bone forward as you press the right thigh into the left leg. Lovely. And then we're going to take that foot back, separate big toe, second toe, pace on that Achilles tendon of your left foot. Reach back into your left hip and use that to press down. And then we're going to come into a side plank, just holding onto the back of that foot. Gently reaching the arms up to the sky. Lift those lovely hips up. And then as we come out into our plank pose, separate off those feet. Exhaling again, you can come through your triangle if you want. Into your upward facing dog if you want. And exhaling back into our downward facing dog. So really find the grounding out in that right foot, right leg. As we inhale, float that left leg up. Bend the knee, keep the shoulders nice and level out as we lift into the knee and reach back into our right heel. And then we'll take that left little toe side to our right little foot side, side edge of the foot, and do the squeeze on. So we're not lifting into the balance here, we're just squeezing right hip forwards, left butt cheek back. You should feel a thigh connection here. Just really stretching out through that IT band of that left leg. So So when we step that left foot back, find your Achilles tendon, reach back into your heel, lift those lovely front shins. Not that you have shins at the back, lift your shins. And then we're going to grip on, rock it out into our side plank. Lift our lovely hips up high. Good, so we're going to connect all the way down to those toes as well. And then as we bring ourselves over, we're in our plank pose, popping the knees down, exhaling, lengthening out to inhale into our cobra, exhaling, down facing dog. Good, so we want three lovely breaths here. Okay, just sort of micro nudging, so just checking the hands are shoulder width, okay, that we're not pushing back so hard that we're pulling the shoulders into the ears. Feel that energy moving from the base of the thumb through the base of the fingers, the finger pads. Good. Lovely. So we're going to take that right leg back up and bring our right knee into pigeon pose, sliding that left leg away. Good. So once we're here, just coming up onto the tippy fingers just to create the length to the spine. Keep curling the toe under and extending that left leg back, making sure it's directly in line with your hip. Okay. Feel your right butt cheeks moving out a little bit. And then that lovely little back stretch here. So nice hip flexor, nice hip, nice back stretch. Love it. And then we'll pull the left fingertips forward, thread the needle of the right arm through. Lovely. Just place the left hand onto the right hand and gently press back a little bit. And so feeling a nice stretch into that left hip, left side body. And then as we bring it forward and swinging that left leg all the way up and over our right leg. Okay. And pop the two sit bones down onto the floor. If that's not working for you, just extend the right leg out in front of you. Lovely little sailboat on right arm, hooked over left thigh. Draw back into this left hip, plant the hand then behind the hip, and gently lift, inhale. And on your exhale, find your gentle turn. You can also take your hand down and just clasp onto your lovely big toe. Good. As much rotation here as you can. Beautiful. And then when we come out to our center, just unhook the legs. Find ourselves nicely slithered onto our sit bones. Float the feet out in front of us. Half boat pose. Better. Good. Pointing out to the toes. Lift the chest, lengthen the spine, relax the shoulders. And then we'll cross those beautiful legs, take it back into our plank pose, pressing out to those beautiful heels. Exhaling again, it can be cobra, it can be upward facing dog. Exhaling into our downward facing dog. Good, so keep finding yourself really growing in stature in your downward facing dog, becoming more sort of powerful, stronger. Rounding into our right heel, we'll throw that left leg up. Come into pigeon pose, left knee. Okay. And gently sliding that right leg away. Really flattening out onto the top of the leg rather than rolling onto the outside edge of the foot. And then coming up onto the tippy fingers. Just gently press back a little bit. Good. Okay, so remember we're occasionally walking that right leg away. We're going to draw that right hip bone forward. Smoothing this left side out a little bit. Breathing up. Breathing. Another big breath here. So in amongst the stretch, finding your relaxation point so that you can move slightly deeper into it. Find out where the resistance is. Is it because there may be a little bit of impingement, and maybe that's where you're going to be, and that is the only place you're going to be, or whether you can just deepen it by just finding that release point and moving it another little bit. Lovely. So we're going to swing that right leg over top of our left leg. Good. And again, you can straighten out this left leg if the two buttocks aren't onto the floor. Reaching up into that left side, stay with the arms and really press down into that right hip. Bring the right hand now behind the hip, lifting up and out of the waist. And as you exhale, beautiful rotation through the spine. So you should feel that lovely separation between the top half and the lower half of the body. Okay. And the shoulders will just gently fall in. So try not to be pulling around with the arm, try and be lengthening and drawing around with the core. Breathe, one more breath. Lovely, and then we'll release the two feet again out in front of us. Ground ourselves onto our sit bones, rock back, okay? Bring the arms out in front and full boat pose this time. Okay, so again, you can come back into your hug. So energizing the legs, so we're either pointing or flexing, okay? We're lifting and lengthening the spine, we're relaxing the shoulders. Center of our head gaze, maybe up past our toes. Now breathe. Lovely. So we'll cross those lovely legs over, taking it back into our plank pose. Exhaling through our vinyasa and cobra. Upward facing dog. You can come through your chaturanga knees on the mat. And all the way back into our downward facing dog. Lovely, we'll float our right leg up. Good. Step that right foot in. Tap the fingers to the floor. Okay, rock it forward, lift that left leg. And then nose to knee. Good, nose to knee. So coming from your standing out, into your nose to knee. Brilliant. And then we'll step that left foot back, low lunge, dropping our back knee, press the pelvis forward, keep the toes curled under in that back foot, and just reach up and back as you send the hips forward. And then we'll take the fingertips on the floor, we'll lift that back knee. So we're quite long, low lunge position, so when we're extending into this, this is a pyramid pose. But we're trying to lengthen that lovely right leg, reaching back into our right heel. Yeah. And then from here, okay, as we bend the right knee, just bring the right butt cheek down to rest onto that right heel and turn to the side of your mat. Hip opening, closing. So internal rotation, toes down. Exhale, push the little toe side back and out. Okay, so just rolling the head. Okay, now that lovely femur into our hip socket. Good. We'll press it out to our left side. Same thing here. Just roll the toes up and down. Brilliant. From here, as we turn out to our left leg, okay, step back into the plank pose, float it down, again, cobra upward facing dog, exhale into our downward facing dog. Good, and inhale, float that left leg up to the sky, step it in, low lunge position, rocking forward, standing L, and nose to knee. Reach. Good. So we're going to come into that standing heel, really pressing back into that heel, lifting our heart center. Lovely. And then we'll step that leg back, drop the back knee, keep the toe curled under, float the arms up, send the hips forward, reach back. Beautiful. And then as we float the hands back down, we're lifting back knee, just gently straightening into our left leg, folding down. Beautiful. So we're going to drop that left heel onto our left, left butt cheek onto our left heel. Rake it all over, to that right side. When we turn to our right foot here, okay, just step back into your plank pose again. Exhale. Up we come. And then all the way back down to facing dog. So just a couple of breaths here now as we move into our balanced flow. So remember, if anything comes just a little bit challenging for you, just step it back a little bit. Lovely. So we'll float our right leg up to the sky. Step right in between the hands, swivel that left heel down. Okay. Inhaling up, Virabhadrasana one, warrior one. Good. So hips forward facing to slide the hands down. Rest onto your right thigh. Maybe interlace them with fingers. Okay. Draw back into your right butt cheek. And just rock body weight forward onto that left big toe. And then as we lift that left leg, float the right leg up. So you don't have to go low, you don't have to go high, you're just trying to find your balance here. Lovely. As we start lowering that left leg, okay, come up, just tip the toes down on the floor to the inside of your left leg, sorry, right leg. Okay. And we'll press into our right leg and bring ourselves up into our tree pose with our left leg. Good. Bringing our hands to heart center. Lovely. Then we go to lower this left foot and bring the left toes behind the right heel. So we have one foot in front of the other and gently fold it down. Good. Once we're here, maybe you can have a block if you need to at the front of your mat. Hopefully it's there. Folding out into this nice forward fold. We're then going to come into our Ardha Uttanasana. So we're going to take our right fingers as our right little toe side. Use our left hand as a balancer, and then just start sending that left leg back up to the sky. From here, as you press into your right big toe, start turning head, neck, shoulders, and chest to the left. Turn that ribcage around another little bit, and another little bit. Good. We're going to bend that knee, find that ankle, push the foot back into the hand, or the shoulder back. Center your eyes where you can keep your balance working for you. Lovely. So reversing that now, back into our Ardha Uttanasana. Good. Settle into it once you're there. Good. Lowering that left hand to the mat, step the left toes behind that right foot again. Forward fold. As we come all the way up, so finding a balance to bring yourself back up, okay? We're going to step that left foot back up into our tree pose. So we're just reversing back to what we came into. Okay. And if you take a little bit lower, my left foot sliding down my leg, it's my excuse. Lovely. So remember how we came into tree pose? Take that left leg back, lean forward, place your right hands, left hands on your right thigh. Whoop. They tell you it'll be wobbly. And then step that left leg back, warrior one. So right leg should be on fire here. Mine certainly is. And then as we come down, all of our left foot will step back into our downward facing dog. And really squeeze out through that right leg. Bring it forward, plank pose. Exhale. Coming either into our cobra or our upward facing dog. So feel everything just gently rinsing out of that right leg. And then we'll take it back into our downward facing dog. So we'll float that lovely left leg up to the sky, step that in, swivel our right heel down, coming up into our warrior side. I need to fix this hair, it's sliding out of its bubble. So in your lovely warrior one, So placing our hands onto that thigh, rolling ourselves forward onto the ball of our right leg. Really smooth into that left leg. Lower the chest wall and lift that right leg up. Good. As we bring that right leg forward, we're just going to tip the toe on the mat, give ourselves a little center point. And then bring ourselves up into our tree pose. Hands to prayer. Heart center above the head. Good. And then as we lower, that right foot has come behind our left foot, toe to heel. And we'll fold down. Nice forward fold. Let me feel you squaring out those feet into the mat. So we're going to use your block for your left hand if you need to. Take it 6 to 10 inches left, little toe side. Right hand is your balance hand. Lift that lovely right leg up to the sky. When you're satisfied, you've found your balance. You're going to turn it through the chest, ribcage, and waist. And then we'll reach back and find that foot. Bend the knee, lift the knee high. Look, so just reversing that, taking the leg out, reaching the arm up. Right hand's coming down, right foot's coming behind the left heel again. Fold it down. So while the blood flowing through that left leg, it's probably tingling at this stage, just breathe into it. As we gently roll ourselves up, so find your balance as you come all the way up. Woo! Lovely. Put the body weight into that left leg. Tree pose with our right leg again. So the foot press into that inside. Lovely. So as we take that lovely right leg back, placing the hands on the thigh, nearly there, reaching it up, and then stepping it back. Warrior one. Exhale and plant the hands, ball of that right foot back into your downward facing dog. Lovely squeeze through those legs. Run. Forward into our plank pose, exhaling, going into our cobra or our upward facing dog. Exhaling, downward facing dog. So just breathe here. Three lovely breaths. You can rock the hips maybe from side to side. Lovely. So from here we'll float up that lovely right leg, step it in between the hands, okay? So once we come into between the hands here, okay, we're going to rock it forward into our standing L. From our standing L, we're reaching back into that left heel. We're going to float our right arm out to the side of the room. Lovely. And then we're going to lift that foot into our right hand this time, lifting the knee up nice and high. Reach it up nice and high and up into the head. Lovely. And then we're going to bend that right knee and take the left thigh to our right calf side. So we're bending down now and finding our balance here. And going to lift that left hand. Breathe. Lovely. As we put the left hand back down, we're lifting that right knee all, sorry, left knee all the way up to the sky. Push the foot into the hand. Lovely. So when we re-extend that left leg into our standing out, right arm's coming out to the side. Yeah, press out to that heel. Brilliant. Lower the hands to the floor. Step that left leg back. Right leg back. Plank pose. Slightly shorter we flow there. Exhale. As we busted it out in the first one. So we're just taking our legs a little bit shorter now. And all the way back into our downward facing dog. And we'll get a nice reach back to those heels. Good, inhale, floating that left leg up. Stepping it in. So finding that lunge position to rock it into a standing L. Pressing back into that right heel. Really lift out that left hip. So we're taking the left arm out in line with the shoulder. Hug the toes in. Nicely balanced as we lift the foot up to the sky and bring that left hand back and send the knee up and foot back. Just breathe. And then we're going to hug. Okay, so right thigh is coming to left calf, rocking it right on the side. Bending deeply into our left knee. Let's release our right hand, chin mudra. Great, put the foot back down. We'll take the knee back up high, push that foot back. So when we're readjusting into our standing L, reach that left arm out. Good, press it back into your lunge position. Left leg goes back, plank pose. Exhaling. Inhale as we further up. Exhale as we bring it all the way back into a downward facing dog. Again, remember you can come into your tabletop, you can rest on your head pose. Lovely. So we'll float the right leg up, we'll just step it in a little bit. Okay, swivel that heel down and just gently bring ourselves up. Okay, from here, okay, want to straighten into that back leg, okay, so instead of having the toe turned out, okay, straighten the foot, okay, and just feel that nice reach down into the left heel, left calf. Good. So there's a nice big calf stretch here, okay, lovely. And then we'll set the feet together, okay, so we're in the middle of the mat. So from here, it's going to be our right leg that we start off with, okay? So just center your elbows out in front of you, okay? And float the arms out and lighten the shoulders, okay? As you press into your left leg, just float your right leg up. Push out to that heel. Good. So we're going to swing the leg through the center point and lower down into our aeroplane warrior three. As we lower the right hand to the mat, oops, we're turning into our Paravitra Ardha Chandrasana, reaching out to that heel. Lovely. As we bring ourselves to the center, lift that right arm up, swing, whoop, the leg through, all the way through again. And then drop that heel down. That's very tough, isn't it, on that leg? Give that leg a shake out. I actually added more onto that, but I've taken it off. Letting the legs are getting a wee bit tired. We'll try the other side. So we're standing on our right leg. We're taking the arms out in line with the shoulders. And then we'll lift that left leg. So as we swing it through, we're coming into our aeroplane warrior three. Yeah. And then we're taking the left hand down and reaching through the right side up to the sky. Just in time, a little bit. Okay. And then from here back into our aeroplane warrior three. And then bring legs a little shake out. Okay, so we stretched out this right calf, left calf. So I'm just going to stretch out that right calf by setting the right foot back and straightening out the legs and the feet. There's a nice way to kind of like squeeze out any tension. Unfortunately, it doesn't squeeze out the wobbles. Lovely. Brilliant. Okay, and then we'll just step the 2 feet together. So we'll do the last balance thing just independently. I was going to add on to that, but just quite fatiguing, isn't it, doing all that? I know we're building our strength and our balance and coordination. I think at some point it just gets a little bit tiring. Lovely. So gently roll up. Okay, so we're going to come into our standing leg extension, holding onto our toe. So separating the feet out a little bit. Have a choice of just taking the arm out in front of you and lifting the leg into it, like this, okay? Or you can simply just bring the leg up and catch the toe, okay? So try the two variations, extending the arm out, okay? And gently lifting the leg, okay? If that doesn't work, if you just bend the knee, reaching out that lovely left arm. We're going to take a nice big breath in and take the right leg out to the right side. Pull against the toe and press the heel away and relax your right shoulder. Reaching it out another little bit here. So we'll stay slightly longer in the standing balance now. To compensate for not adding it in to our last little flow. Good. And then we'll bring it back to centre. We'll release the two arms up. And we'll gently lower that leg. Lovely, give the shoulders a little roll. Let's try the other side. So we'll bring that nice standing balance. So remember, you take the arm out in front of you, okay? Or you can just bend the knee. So try it first. See if it works for you. It doesn't matter if you can roll into it. Once you grab the toe, straighten it out. Whoa. Right arm's going out to the side. And then we'll swing that left leg out. Press down to the heel. A good pull against that left big toe, relaxing the shoulders. Centering the elbows. Float the arms up. Lovely. And relax down that leg. Your nice big inhale and sit it into the chair pose. Chair pose, float it down, fall. Forward fold. Inhaling into a half. And then we'll plant the hands. I'm just going to come down onto our knees. Okay, so you can go up to against the wall if you want for your headstand. You can fold your mat over. Okay, so just coming into our lovely hands on the floor rather than our forearms. So since we're not coming into the triangle, we're coming into the tripod. So we're going to plant the hands firmly onto the mat, shoulder width apart. As we roll forward from the crown of the head, from the forehead onto the crown of the head, just making sure that the elbows are directly, okay, over the heels of the hands. We can see in between our legs directly upside down. Okay, and we're pressing the hands onto the floor like we would in downward facing dog. Okay, we're going to curl the toes under and lift the knees. Hug those elbows in. Okay. And gently place one knee on one tricep and then maybe the other one. Good. So even if that's just where you're at the minute, okay, lifting a knee onto the tricep, maybe popping that foot down and swapping it around, okay, really engaging the core, magnetizing the inside elbows. You just want to shift the hips over the shoulders and bring the knees towards each other so that we're hugging in, okay. Lovely. Then if you feel confident, you can extend the legs up to the sky. And flex your feet, you can have pointy feet. Okay, whatever feels good for you. I feel like you're really lengthening your spine here. So you can be up against the wall here. So you've got something to rest your feet on. Just breathe. Lovely. So we're coming down, we're going to kind of round the back a little bit to lower the knees. Separate the knees, place them onto the triceps again. Lovely. Step one leg down, step the other leg down. Gently come onto the knees, soften onto the tops of the feet, and just bring the forearms forward and lower the head. Just relaxing to the back of the neck. Lovely, and then we'll gently roll up. Good. Cross the legs over. Bring our bums back into the middle of that. Lie down. And give those knees a super duper hug. So from here, we'll extend that left leg. Hug that lovely weight thigh in nice and deeply into the chest. Okay, now you can let it ping back to its natural space. You can keep it quite high up to bring it over to the left side, smoothing onto the shoulder blades, reaching out into that left leg. And we'll gently turn our gaze to the right. Into our center plank. Another little hug in, right leg goes away. Little extra draw in. And then we can sweep it over to the right side. Gently relaxing into our left shoulder. So just really feel like any tension. Okay, so when you're working through balance and transition, it can be very challenging, so just let everything go now. Super, and then as we come back into our center point, we'll just give ourselves one last little hug. And then as we gently pop the feet to the mat, we can send the legs away in Shavasana. We can just simply walk them out, let the knees roll in. And close the eyes just for 5 breaths here now. Just bring in a nice sense of closure to your session. Just letting it go so you can move on with the rest of your day. Energize, stretch out. Exhale, feel like you could breathe out forever. There's only all the sounds of the day around you, just gently drift on. No need to engage. Lovely. So from here, we're just going to lift the hands and give them a lovely rub together. Just generating as much heat as we can on the palms of the hands. Absolutely freezing in here, so I could be here all day. Just which will hopefully get them the most warm soon enough. And then place the heels and hands on the cheekbones and just cup the eyelids with the palms of the hands, fingertips on the forehead. Lovely. Just bring yourself right here right now. Lovely. And then we'll just shake out those hands. Tuck the knees in. Give myself a lovely hug and a little roll. Well done, everybody. Thank you for joining me today. My apologies at the uber amounts of wobbling I did. Have a lovely day. Namaste.